Well, howdy, 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 folks. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. I wanted to talk to you about something that I saw yesterday. I was visiting a vendor and you know, I put the title as, you know, he could, especially, but anybody can make more money per hour without increasing customers, without doing anything really. There's some tips. I just put out a blog article about it today, but this is something a little different. This is something where we're going to talk about complacency. And where this comes in is vendors become complacent. They start doing good, and then they slowly start to lose that loving feeling. They kind of start pulling back and not doing as good a job as when they started. And so here's what I noticed immediately, and it took me by surprise, because this, hey James, this vendor I didn't expect it from, and so it's over in Tennessee, up north near Morristown, Tennessee, if you've ever been in that area. But anyway, here's some things I noticed. It has a swooper flag, and it is faded and looks like crap. Okay, it doesn't look good. He'd be better off without the swooper flag. It shouldn't be there now, because it's so faded that it just is junky. And swooper flags aren't that expensive. And I'm going to go through some fixes as soon as I get through telling you or sharing with you the things that I noticed immediately when I pulled up. Another one. This was yesterday, so the faded signs, the cart was dirty. And I don't mean like food everywhere on it, gross like that. I mean dirty, like been run down the road a lot in rain and nasty. So the shine was gone. There was mud splashed up, you know, on the sides where it splashes off the road from, you know, the pool car, the car he's towing it with. And it just didn't look good. Even right there on the front where the burner holes are, it was muddy. And look like crap. Like I wouldn't want to eat off that. And I didn't. I chose not to eat just because it looked so ratty. Now, hey Metalhead, Dave's here. Thank you for being here. Anyway, so I began looking around, because I was going, I had been there a year ago and it wasn't anything even remotely resemble this look. So a year ago looked fantastic. Now, not so much. Another one was, they have a condiment caddy, and it's one of those San Jamar condiment caddies with the plastic lid. It's black with a plastic lid. And the plastic used to be clear, and now it's sun faded to the point that it looks dirty all the time. So it doesn't even appear to be clean. Even it could have been clean. It might have been clean, but we wouldn't have known, because it now appears dirty. Now, I don't know if you can buy replacement San Jamar lids. You probably can, but San Jamar condiment caddies aren't horribly expensive, and if it meant you had to invest in one every year, what the heck. Condiment table had a little like a, it's a picnic style condiment table. Sitting beside the cart with some condiments on it and some other things. But the condiment table was sitting, this is a gravel lot, and right in front of the condiment table was a hole, like a mud hole. And it had been raining the day or two prior, but it was like a, you know, nasty. It was muddy there. And even though it was gravel, it was a lot of mud and dirt there in that hole. So where the customer would have to do is walk around behind the condiment table, not the part facing them, and get their condiments standing in the hole, or go around it and not stand in a hole. It was just like, okay, why'd you put that there? So then the one of the other things that I noticed that just, this grossed me out, and maybe it's just me, but I would advise you, because my wife is the same way, and had she been there, she would have definitely not eaten. But they have a pickle jar set up, and we teach vendors to have pickle jars, because in some areas, pickle jars pickles do great, these big pickles. Some vendors doing pickles on a stick for $1, some do them for $2. You can make a killing with pickles, okay? So it's just a great side item. Well, this vendor has a pickle jar, and it is so sun-faded, the pickle label on the jar. I don't know if they're taking pickles out of a 5-gallon bucket, because you can buy them in 5 gallons, and putting them in that jar. But the label is now so sun-faded, it looks like you bought it when that grocery store that closed 10 years ago finally got out of bankruptcy and sold all their old foods. And that's what it looked like. It looked like an old jar of pickles. And it wasn't appealing to me. Now, if it's the case, this vendor's moving pickles from a 5-gallon jug or tub to the jar, which a lot of us do, make your own label. Create your own label or splurge and get you a clear jar or scrape the freaking paper off that jar. It's clear anyway. People are going to be able to tell that it's pickles. And if you put pickles $1 or pickles $2, they'll really know it's pickles. They'll see the pickles. They read the pickles. We got it covered. And I'm going to go through some of the things that I would do immediately. One, I would change the signs. I would change those out immediately to something that is not sun-faded, ripped, tattered, torn, and looks dirty. Okay, one of the signs on the ground that leans up just has, it's like vinyl lettering on a white coroplast, which is like a plastic sign. On that sign had dirt on it, mud on it, where I don't know how it got muddy, but maybe from people sloshing around in the mud hole in front of the condiment table. But because it was right next to that, so that's probably where it got it. But it looked yucky. The whole setup didn't look appealing. Now, I asked him, I said, how are you doing, And he goes, oh, I do pretty good, normally, a couple hours, 2.5. I think he's out there 2.5 hours. He said about $250 a day. Freaking great. But what if he could make $330 a day for the same amount of time? Wouldn't you do it? I would. I mean, I would do that. I would not dare risk my business. I'm out there anyway, okay? I'm out there anyway. Why not be the best that I can be? And here's some other fixes. The condiment caddy, replace the freaking thing. Replace it. I don't care if you buy the cheapest piece of crap condiment caddy. It'll look better for a little while and then get you another one. And keep doing it. Figure it into the cost of doing business and looking clean and present yourself well. And I'd want you to ask yourself a question. If the mayor was coming today to your cart, or your pastor was coming to your cart bringing his wife and kids to eat, or if your mother-in-law was coming to your cart to eat, would you go out of your way to make everything perfect? Like make it look good, clean, wipe down the sides of the cart. I mean, that takes all of 2.5 minutes. And you do these things, you would do these things. Most people would go, yeah, I'm going to do that especially if the mayor's coming, right? Or my mother-in-law, I don't want her talking to my wife behind my back about how nasty I am. So then why wouldn't you do that every day? Because we don't know what customer's going to come up that's going to turn into a $40,000 a year private gig at the Ford dealership. We don't know which customer that shows up is going to see that nasty pickle jar and would have asked me to host their employee benefit program twice a year, their meet and greet thing with clients. Who knows? But vendors are doing those things. But I'll guarantee you this vendor is not getting jack squat in jobs, private gigs, because ain't nobody walking up to that cart and thinking, I'd love to have him in my backyard serving my friends and family. I'm blown away he does $250 a day. Blown away, if that's true. But there are vendors that are doing those kinds of numbers. They're like complacent. So maybe this vendor was doing $400 a day and then I can get by on 200. Well, you can get by on not washing your feet because you don't want to bend over because you've been married for 22 years. But you're a moron. If you do that, bend over, take the time, take the effort, and wash your freaking feet. Well, this is your business. When you go out into the public, it's like creating an ad and then going, here's my ad. All the cat crapped on it. Sorry about that, but we do have good hot dogs. Nobody wants that. Do you see my point there? So make the best of your 2 hours, 3 hours there. Does it take you a little bit more effort, just a tiny bit more effort to go, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this. Oh, he was out of mustard. He was out of mustard. I said, I would just stop setting up real quick when I figured it out and ran to the store. And he goes, eh, it doesn't matter. I'll bring it next time. It's not the end of the world, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, no, no. Something important like that, are you using a list? Well, usually I use a list. And so we have these lists on Learn Hot Dogs that you can just download. And now you've got a checklist so you know to take your stuff, right? Even the best vendors still use a checklist. Because it is common for us to have 900,000 things on our mind. We want to make sure we can make it to the emergency fishing trip later. And we ain't thinking, did I grab the mustard when we get in the car? We usually think about it once we get there. So if you have a checklist and you make sure you have everything, then you can go prepared. So there's proof of this complacency. Complacency meaning, I don't want to bend over and wash my feet. My wife ain't leaving me. We've been married 22 years. That's complacency. That's somebody who just doesn't want to move forward, is happy where they're at. They're happy with the status quo. They're like, yeah, you know, I could have made more. I could have picked up that $20 off the ground, but dang, that's a long ways down to the ground, you know, and I'm okay. I got money. I got a dollar or two in my pocket. What do I care? That's complacency. That's kind of the get-by attitude. And it's what separates typically entrepreneurs from people that work regular JOBs because complacency is easy to, it's reliable. It's like, okay, I found my rut and I'm going to stay in my rut. But this guy was kicking butt a year ago. He was doing fantastic. It was last October I was there, a year ago October. And he was kicking butt. And now he's like, I still do pretty good, still doing pretty good. And I'm like, dude, just aggravates me. Okay, so those are the, here's another solution to the mud hole and all that. Move the freaking cart over 5 feet. Don't set your condiment table in front of a mud hole. If you're in a dirt lot, like we had the vendor I did the cart critique on, he was on the side of a highway in Florida, and I had him go get a remnant piece of green outdoor carpet. Go get you a 10 by 12 or something, or a 10 by 10 piece of outdoor carpet. Easy to roll up, easy to fold up and put in your truck. And put that under your cart. And now you look clean. And outdoor carpet's easy. Like if somebody spills some mustard that you didn't bring on your outdoor carpet, you can just spray it off with a water hose. It's like magic. So it just makes things look better, keeps the dust down. Those are the extra steps that you should be doing, and most vendors do in the beginning. They do these things and then later go, oh my gosh, man, I don't wanna do the checklist today because that takes me like 15 and a half seconds. I'm gonna miss Jerry Springer. You have to stay motivated, and sometimes it's why I'm doing this. You have to keep in your head, I'm going to do these things every day that I go out. If you get to feeling like, you know what, I'm going to just kind of half butt this. I don't really need to do all this work and stuff. And then take a week off, take 2 weeks off till you feel rejuvenated enough to do it the right way. Don't let yourself burn out to the point that you're a slowly decline downhill progress path to crapville. Because what's ultimately going to happen if he doesn't make changes immediately, he will go out of business. There isn't a gob of people that want to eat off a nasty cart. And I can't imagine them wanting to do that every week, every week, every week. Sure, there's some, but not enough to make a happy income. Let's see. I'm looking through the comments if you're wondering where I went. I think that was all my notes. Let me see. Matt says, Ben, just set my plan review off to, or sent my plan review off to the health department. Things are finally rolling. Champaign, Illinois. I've been there. I have filmed a vendor there. Colonel Mustard's last stand. And it wasn't really his last stand. He had three last stands. And Champaign is a kick butt place. The University of Illinois, what is it? The Illini campus. Freaking beautiful town. Nice people. That is a great place to make a lot of money. Now, I don't know who stepped in because Big Dick there, that was Richard Chapman that ran those carts and owned those carts. He has since passed away. And so I don't know if somebody else took that over or what happened, but man, Matt, you're in for some fun. And that place, I stayed there 2 days and filmed. I loved it. Brian says, I'd love to sit down and tell you all the gross crap I've seen at festivals. Brian, I've seen it. I've been to the festivals. You should see it. One of the worst ones I ever saw was in Bonnaroo about 8 years ago. And the worst stuff I've ever seen was there. I had a vendor this a couple weeks ago send me some pictures. I wish I'd have pulled those up. I didn't plan on talking about this. But anyway, she sent me some pictures. She was at an event the other day recently. And a couple weeks ago, and she sent me pictures of the other vendors, and some of them you would have laughed. Like, you were like, why did you come out here like this? Who's going to eat that from you? You have chewing tobacco in your goatee, and your freaking shirt has chewing tobacco stains on it. Freaking gross. Chester says he's joining VU soon. You'll love VU. I just bought a hot dog cart. Wish me luck. E-more, I'm wishing you luck. You don't need luck. You know that. Luck is great. I like luck. I like when luck happens. But you don't need luck to make it in this business. You need just to do these things, do these steps. You will win. So go to learnhotdogs.com. It's free. Okay? All the information there is free. Grab that information, start doing it. Make yourself a plan. Like Michael Wood says, make a plan, work the plan. I think there's some other steps in there, but it essentially comes down to make a plan, work the plan. Steven, my wife and I are going to buy a new hot dog cart in the spring, watching all the videos. Congratulations, Steven. That will be a blast. Here's what I would do. Get prepared now. Get all the stuff, start practicing. You can pretend like you already have a cart and start practicing. Do the friends and family. Do your taste test. Do your signs. Do your logos. Do your stuff. Find out everything you need. Start talking to potential places to vend. You can send a picture. You can give them a picture. Check this out. You can give them a picture and go, hey, here's the cart we've got coming. We've got this cool menu. If you have any suggestions, we'd love to hear them because we're not starting until April 5th. But I've already lined up some gigs, but I wanted to see how you'd like it if we'd come and vend here one of the Thursdays of the first 2 weeks we're here or when we get started. Now, you see how I worded that. I said, how would you like it if we did? And then I'd follow it up. Look, there's no charge to you. We'll just come set up, feed your customers. You're going to love us. Your customers are going to really love us. You will kick butt if you do it that way. Thank you so much for the great lessons. Want to start ASAP. Live in South Carolina. A little concerned over tight regs here. The only bad reg in South Carolina, really, there's two. Okay, I said the only. The only two bad regs in South Carolina is they have this, the only one that'll probably affect you, is they have this thing. We want the whole cart covered with basically a Petri dish so that you have warm, moist air come up out of the cart, get trapped in this plastic wrap thing you've created, this plexiglass contraption you've created. That way the bacteria has a good place to grow. That is literally against NSF codes, ANSI codes. That's against it. But South Carolina does it. They're the only state that thinks that's a good idea. So I've made fun of it for years. I've actually talked to their director. The director thinks it's ridiculous. They are going to try to change that. And some inspectors in South Carolina don't require it. They ignore the rule and go, yeah, as long as you cover the steam pans, you know, with a lid, you're good. And here's the cool thing, Christopher. Let me say this real quick. I know you're concerned about getting started. All these things, these red tape things, they're once and done. They're once and done. You go through it. It's easier than starting any other type of business, pretty much, and you're going to make more money. So it's worth that effort to do it and then just be done. So I wouldn't worry about it. Gabrielle's in the house. How you doing? From New Mexico, Albuquerque. Brian says, bring your own condiments. I can get it. Trying to cater in Georgia, don't have a cart. Do I need anything from the health department? You will need to contact the health department, or you can just Google it. I've got some links to Georgia on the Learn Hot Dogs blog, and off the top of my head, I don't remember what they do. Have a cottage law there, which allows you to even have no commissary. So check with them, because that falls under agriculture instead of the health department. But it's doable. Yes. Logical Sense says, did not know you were live right now. I am live right now. Like literally right now. Okay. Any tips for beginner hot dog stand in San Diego? Finding cart with a griddle, fridge, and 3-compartment sink is hard to find. Are you trying to find a new one? Because if you are, we have them. There's a plug. If you're looking for a used cart or other manufacturers, there's manufacturers that make some great carts for California, or just like what you're talking about. I'd first check with the health department. I've got some stuff on the free training site. If you go to learnhotdogs.com/start, there's some basic steps. That'll help get you an idea of what you're going to be required in San Diego for getting started. But we have vendors in San Diego, so it's all doable. By joining a union for vendors, how does that... We don't have a union. I don't know of any unions for vendors. We just have a group that's a private group. That way people can share, oh, I had a bad day, but here's what I did yesterday. You know, and that's the kind... It's a place to voice your concerns, get tips and help from seasoned vendors. There's even people in there that are new that just came out of the gate kicking butt. And it's because they owned, you know, a Radio Shack for 22 years and they learned some marketing tips. So they're sharing that their advice there of something they learned. So it's you get the benefit of a lot of experience in vending and the benefit of a lot of people that have been in business before that are helping each other get better. And just a great place. Let's see. Anyway, that's it. I thank you for being here. I always make these live ones too long. I apologize for that, but I wanted to cover that and the problem with complacency, the problem with doing things that way. And this vendor could be making more an hour just by being cleaner. And I just made up the figure of $40 an hour. He could make a lot more than that. He could get all kinds of private gigs. He could do so much better had he not got complacent and started letting things slack. You know, all willy-nilly'ing it with his vending business. Anyway, love you. Thanks for being here. Talk to you later.